I said you will have answer. You know, the Bible says money answers all things. Where money problem arises, you will have answer. You will have answer. You will have answer. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, no more shall you be called forgotten. No more shall you be called forsaken. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. One more scripture about that, and I want us to pray about it. Amen. Isaiah chapter 60. Thank you, Jesus. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 15. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 15. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 15. It said, though you were once despised and hated. Once despised and hated. Praise the name of the Lord. God will give you all your haters answer. God will surprise them. You know how God is going to do it? He's going to give you favor. He's going to give you a result. He's going to give you a miracle that is bigger than their expectation. He's going to give you something that will make you laugh. Like Hannah that said, now I can rejoice. Amen. He said, though you were once despised and hated, and with no one traveling through you, no one want to associate with you. They say, oh, no, not that one. We are not at our level, at his level. He said, they despise you, they hated you, they don't want to associate with you. He said, I will make you beautiful forever. Come on, say, I am beautiful forever. He said, a joy to all generation. Hallelujah. Look at what he says there. You see it? He said, no, there's no one went through you. He said, I will make thee an eternal excellency, a joy of many generations, a joy of many generations, a joy of many generations, a joy of many generations. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want you to pray and say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, rise from today. In the name of Jesus Christ, I shall not be forsaken. I shall not be despised. Wherever has been despised, wherever has been forsaken and hated, I become an eternal excellence. I become an eternal, come on, somebody praying. I become a victor. I become a celebration. In the name of Jesus Christ, I shall be celebrated. Come on, say, I shall be celebrated. I shall be celebrated. My destiny shall not see shame. My destiny shall not see reproach. My destiny shall not suffer devastation. I shall be celebrated. In the name of Jesus Christ, my children shall be celebrated. In the name of Jesus Christ, wherever you have been forsaken and hated, they will come back and bow to you. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ, so shall it be. Come and say, I receive it today. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' most glorious name we pray. Father, we thank you for this morning. We give you praise because your presence is here. Your glory is here. Your power is here. Lord, Father, everything that you are set to do in this service, do it in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your glory be seen. Let your power be made manifest. Open the windows of heaven and pour down your blessing upon us. Let your mighty, mighty power be made available in this place. Thank you, mighty God. We worship you. We magnify you. We lift your name higher. We say thank you, Jesus. For our family, we say thank you. For this ministry, we say thank you. Oh, we thank you. We thank you, we thank you. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Hallelujah to your name. In Jesus' most glorious name we have prayed. Let's put our hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated in the heavenly, heavenly places in Jesus' name. I am so happy to be in the presence, in the house of God. Come on, what about you? What about you? What about you? Amen, amen. You know, I was sharing yesterday with a group that I met with. I said, God spoke to me years ago. I remember I was talking to somebody in the group was saying, when I came to the church, oh God, Destiny Star. And I said, you know, God gave me the name Destiny Star for this church because he spoke to me years ago. He said, everyone that is born
of God has a destiny. And every destiny has a star. And every star is made to shine. Praise the name of the Lord. And I believe it strongly in my heart that your star will shine. You are, listen to me, what is about your life and about your destiny is about to be unleashed. It's about to be unveiled in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And devil cannot hold you down. No power of the enemy can restrict you. That's what God is set to do in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Amen, amen. I think I'm just going to flow like this. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us open our Bible to the book of Mark. Mark chapter 11. Thank you, Jesus. Actually, let's go to Matthew. Let me start from Matthew. Matthew chapter 17, verse 19 to 21. We have been talking about this month is a month of empowerment. And the first Sunday, I talk about the empowerment by the power of prayer. To get empowered through prayer. And last week we talked about to get empowered through the word of God. That you have to soak yourself in the word of God. That you dwell in the word of God by studying, reading, and meditating on the word of God. And we also say that you should speak the word of God. That you don't just, you know, listen to it. You should be the doer of the word, that you are walking in the word of God. You are a doer of the word of God. And we say you should speak the word. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. That the word you speak is what you get. Hallelujah. And, you know, today we're going to be going, we're going to be making, taking it to the next level. Everybody say the next level. Matthew chapter 17, verse 19 to 21. It said, then the disciples came to Jesus privately and said, why could we not cast it out? Because Jesus sent them out to heal the sick, to cast out demons. And they have this demon and it was so difficult to cast out. So Jesus answered them, because of your unbelief. For actually, I say to you, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. And nothing will be impossible for you. Come on, say, nothing will be impossible for me. And he said, nothing will be impossible for you. However, this kind does not go except by prayer and fasting. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in Jesus' name. Now, we've been talking about empowerment. God is the God of power. And the Bible says he giveth power to the weak. Amen. And those who are weary, he actually increases their strength. Those who are fainting, he increases their strength. So that you can run like and you can soar like the eagles. Praise the name of the Lord. You can run and never be weary. Now, we are in the middle of the year. We have about 6 months ahead of us. It is my prayer that you will be strong. You will be so much empowered that you will run and you will not be weary. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will walk and you will not faint. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And in every circumstance, you will overcome because you will become an overcomer. In the precious name of Jesus Christ. So we are in the season that I believe that God is going to inculcate something powerful inside of you. And that's why we started with prayer. Prayer is a master key for your empowerment. Amen. That's why we have a saying, a powerful Christian is a prayerful Christian. If you are prayerful, you are powerful. If you are prayerful, you will not be a prey to the enemy. If you are prayerful, when the enemy comes like a wind, you will rise up. The Bible said the Spirit of God will raise a standard against them. That Spirit of God is activated in the place of prayer. Praise the name of the Lord. And when you soak yourself in the word of God, you are powerful. Jesus had the word of God inside him. And when he was tempted, he says, it is written. And Satan couldn't hold him down. The Bible says, at the point, the enemy left him alone for a while. So the word of God is very powerful. Because the word of God is yes and amen. The word of God is an authority of a believer. Amen. The Bible said, nothing broken in the word of God. The word of God cannot be broken. So as it is, so it is. So, declare the word of God. Believe the word of God. Walk in the light of the word of God. Have the word of God guide your family. Let the word of God guide your business. Let the word of God guide the way of your operation as a kingdom citizen. You will be surprised of how you will be elevated in life, because the word of God is elevated than the word of than the name of God himself. And that the word of God has integrity. That means whatever he says he will do, it will do. Praise the name of the Lord. If you say you are here, believe it that I am here, because the word of God says so. Because the word of God says so. The doctor can say contrary, but you have to believe what the word of God says. And that is why today we're going to be talking about the power of faith. Amen. You see, there's no way you talk about the power. The faith that you have in God is what unleashed the power of God in you. You can pray, but if you don't have faith, amen, your prayer is zero. You can have the word of God inside you, but if you don't believe the word that you just read, it's nothing. Praise the name of the Lord. It doesn't work until faith is activated. It doesn't make any difference until the faith is at work. And that is why today is so important that we understand the power and the creative power of faith as we walk as believers, as children of God. And I pray that we make a difference in your life today. Are you ready for the word of God? Amen. So, Matthew chapter 17, verse 19 to 20, it says, and the disciple asking, why can't we cast out this devil? We have prayed, we have fasted, we have done all this thing, but there is something. Then God said, Jesus said, because of your unbelief, if you have faith, you will say to any mountain, move, and it will move. Amen. You will command the mountain to shift, and it will shift. There is so much power and authority that we have as a believer, but those power can only be unleashed by the instruments of faith. And that is why I submit to you today that I pray that the faith in the living God will possess your heart, will possess your spirit, and you will operate beyond the ordinary in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That right from today, from now to the end of this year, nothing will be impossible for you. Nothing will restrict you. Nothing will be natural, because the faith in God will be in activation in your life, and nothing will be impossible anymore in the name of Jesus Christ. Giants will bow before you. All your prayers will be answered. You will command a thing to go, it will go for you. You command something to come, they will come for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, because faith is the instrument that you need. So he said to them, he said, because of your unbelief, and I said to you, if you have faith As a mustard seed, just more faith. It doesn't have to be enough, a lot. Just have faith. You see, faith is so simple. And that's why Jesus himself said, let the little children come to me. If you have faith like these little children, you are set for life. But many times, the reason why our faith is so restricted is because many of us adults, we have had so much experiences. Ha! It didn't happen that way the other time. It didn't happen to that person. You think God is going to heal me? Ha! That other person died of that sickness. Hey! Then you think it is your own turn. Then the word of God become, you put the word of God aside. You say, oh, that's not what we are talking about. We are talking about reality. What is reality to you? The reality must be the word of God. The reality must be the efficacy, the power in the word of God. Must be what God says that you believe. That is your reality. That must be your reality. Outside of God's word, your natural experience cannot be compared to what God wants to do in your life.
I'm telling you, if you move only by your reasoning, only by your natural experience, you will have natural results. Amen.